is infrared, and we're in Elizabeth, New Jersey, so that you don't have to be. This is the Elizabeth stop on New Jersey Transit's Northeast Corridor and North Jersey coastlines. And as we approach 400 subscribers, this is in the year that we've been walking and recording. This is our first visit to New Jersey. How do you like it so far? We choose Elizabeth for our first visit to New Jersey. Is this sign really necessary? I should mention it's Earth Day, April 22nd, 2023, 11:30 in the morning. So not quite noon on Earth Day, and we're in Elizabeth, New Jersey. So we're going to do something very earthy today. We are going to avail ourselves of one of the first opportunities to walk from this part of New Jersey to walk to New York. So in addition to this wonderful clock tower that they have on, I think might have been the original Elizabeth Station building. You can see, it looks like maybe there was an intersecting rail line here, which doesn't exist anymore. So if you've ever taken Amtrak from between Philadelphia and New York, you've doubtless seen this station clock tower. Anyway. We are going on this Earth Day to walk over the Gothels Bridge to Staten Island. I was saying before that in our first year, we've never been to New Jersey. Similarly, we've never been to Staten Island. We've been to the other four boroughs, but never Staten Island. So today we're going to walk from New Jersey to Staten Island and kill two birds with one stone. But no real birds will be harmed.
iPhone 7, Sonya, iPhone 7 Plus, iPhone 6 Plus, iPhone 7 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 Plus, iPh
never knew. I wonder if pedestrians ever get to cross in this direction. Crosswalks are quite a bit narrower here than in New York. How's that for insight? Street now. Please don't let me die in Elizabeth. Is this a high school built without windows? Well, what is it? I don't know what this body of water is, but I think we have to follow it. All right. Some quick research on Google Maps says that doesn't name this body of water per se, but it seems to say that the road or the path that we're on is Elizabeth River Parkway. Now, do they mean that it is River Parkway within the city of Elizabeth, or is it the parkway along the Elizabeth River? Tops of these street lamps look just like those in Central Park on the other side of the river. still current. So, trees being planted, and is this a real path? Is it a desire line? Is it to be developed, paved? It looks a little iffy, technical term. Those are protective dogs. I mean, where's the closest house? Unless they're in the wild. And this lovely view on the horizon, I think, is the first visible part of the ExxonMobil North Jersey refinery. I don't know a more specific name than that. by the way, if you're intent on walking from this general area in New Jersey to Staten Island over the new Gothels Bridge, which I think we may be seeing in the distance when we round this curve. So I will say a little bit about the bridge. Well, what I was going to say before is there's a variation of this walk which would begin at Newark Airport, which is actually in, I think, the town or the city of Elizabeth. It's a longer walk from there, but you could basically pick it up where we started soon thereafter. So, here is the Gothels Bridge, the new Gothels Bridge, the five-year-old approximately Gothels Bridge, which connects, I think it's still Elizabeth, New Jersey, to Staten Island. Not quite sure what neighborhood. We'll see when we get there. But this is the replacement Gothels Bridge for the original that was built, I think opened in 1928, one of the first infrastructure projects of the newly created Port of New York Authority, which, despite its the New York centricity of its corporate title, was governed nearly equally by the states of New Jersey and New York. Of course, as everyone knows, in the early 70s, the corporate name was changed to the Port Authority of New York and New Jersey. Nice car. Now, to the left of the Gothels Bridge, you see a vertical lift bridge, vertically lifted. Oh. The signs, good. It's good that they have these signs here. In New York City, they have two different places where you can report it to the City Department of Environmental Protection through 311, or to the State Department of Environmental Conservation. And each sign of that type is posted with the specific ID number for that sewer outfall. And the ID number is alphanumeric, with the alpha part being an abbreviation for the wastewater treatment plant that would normally be receiving and treating that sewage, instead of your seeing it flow into the Elizabeth River. Besides these, what looks like two family homes, are the apartments. We have, in the distance, container port cranes. We have fuel storage tanks. And as we said earlier, way in the distance, we'll see it better in a minute, the ExxonMobil refinery. So, the lift bridge to the left is a railroad bridge. If my history is correct, it carried the Baltimore and Ohio Railroad from here nearby in New Jersey to Staten Island. And there was a freight railroad line that ran all the way up the north shore of Staten Island. I think that same north shore line at one time also had a passenger railroad. And the Baltimore and Ohio was the owner until MTA took it over in the early 70s. Of the Staten Island Railroad. Staten Island, I don't remember what it was called back then, maybe Staten Island Rapid Transit. And the railroad bridge here, this lift bridge, went unused, I think, for decades. And then, as part of an effort to revitalize a port in Staten Island, whose name is slipping me right now, they rehabilitated the railroad lift bridge. They rehabilitated or created a freight railroad yard in Staten Island, and the Department of Sanitation on Staten Island built a facility that receives the household waste from trucks and then containerizes it into sealed containers, and then leave from that facility. The sealed containers can leave by either rail or boat. I'm not sure about the boat part. Crossing here, and where do we go from here? More of a practical than a philosophical or long-term question. Here we cross this street coming up, whole place. And then if Google Maps is correct, we should see a bike and pedestrian path leading to and possibly over the Gothels Bridge. Now, why Gothels? Well, on the Port Authority's own website, Gothels, I believe General Gothels, was a builder of, or he had a principal role in building the Panama Canal, and later became a consulting engineer. I think the Port Authority said their first consulting engineer.
Wait.
And so this bridge is named after him. Again, originally built in 1928, but for the first 90 years of its existence, from 1928 to 2018, that's 90 years, right? What is that thing across the street? Oh, okay. So, in the first 90 years of its existence, the Gothels Bridge, from 1928 to 2018, there was no bike path, there was no pedestrian path, only motor vehicles could cross. There was really at the outer edge of at least the northbound lane, as I recall, there was just a space just wide enough for maintenance people to provide them like a very narrow walkway, but totally unsuitable for regular pedestrians like us or bikers. So, as we can see in the distance, the sign, Gothels Bridge Pedestrian and Bike Path. All we have to do is cross the street here, and over here, drinking fountain, which, let's see, it actually is dispensing water, which is a pleasant surprise. In New York City, at least in past years, the drinking fountains were not activated each year until like May 15th, maybe even Memorial Day weekend. So, here we are, and since we've been on this walk a pretty long time, we are going to end right here at the, I guess, end of the Elizabeth River Trail. As it says, you are here. Before we enter the Gothels Bridge shared use path to New York. a convenient name to remember. Our next video will be a walk across the bridge from Elizabeth, New Jersey to Staten Island. And then we're going to try and find a bus in Staten Island that will be part of the quickest route to Brooklyn. This is Infrared, and this is what you've been watching.